The city of Iga in northwestern Mie Prefecture is an old castle town. It has a population of about 100,000. It gained importance due to its strategic location close to the ancient capitals of Nara and Kyoto.
Hello, I'm William Reed. I've come here to Iga, the most famous ninja village in Japan. And I'm really psyched about this because I've been in the martial arts for over 40 years myself. And I've come here now to learn firsthand about the ninja secrets and traditions.
William Reed has practiced Aikido for 41 years. Drawing on his extensive knowledge of traditional martial arts, he conducts teaching programs in many countries around the world. Iga Ueno Castle was originally built 450 years ago. In the streets around the castle grounds, there are many traditional Japanese buildings that give visitors a sense of the town's long history.
Oh, look, there's a character for shinobi, which means ninja. That's a reminder that ninja used to live around here, and possibly a warning that they could appear anytime.
William has heard there's a house where there are real ninja. He heads off to find it.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa. Irasshaimase.
Ninja yashiki desu ne.
Hai.
Annai shite itadakimasu ka?
Hai, ima kara annai sasete itadakimasu.
Yoroshiku onegai shimasu.
Kono o heya ni wa ironna shikake ga aru n desu.
Totoba.
Teki ga kita という shirase o ukeru to kochira desu.
Wow, did you see how fast she disappeared? Oh, and she's back. Well, so this is a revolving door.
Sekkaku nande yatte mite.
Not easy to do this quietly. I think they'd know I was behind the door.
Ninja は武器をこの床板の下に隠してある。
この下にですか？
そうです。
どのようにですか？
普段は歩いても何も起こらないんですが。
Looks like an ordinary floorboard.
端を押すと。
Oh. Wow.
武器が出せるようになって。
You've got a sword and what else? Whoa. And shuriken. There's a whole cache of weapons here hidden under the floorboard.
橋を踏むと簡単に開くようになっているんですね。
Many of the ninja houses that remain in Iga have hidden chambers like these. The aim was to prevent their secrets from being stolen by enemy spies. Secrets such as how to make and use gunpowder.
William-san.
川上先生ですか。
は
じめまして、ウィリアム・リードと申します。
Jin-ichi Kawakami is the 21st head of the Ban family from Koga, another town famous for its ninja. He's taught many people the skills and secrets of the ninja. William is looking forward to learning more.
You're an Aikido master, correct?
そうですね、41年ぐらいやってるんですけれども。
Very good. Let's meet here tonight.
はい、ありがとうございます。
The city of Iga has another secret. It's the food that gave the ninja strength when they were in action.
わあ、素晴らしい。
お肉が入ります。
やばそう。
In Japan, this beef is rated just as highly as the better-known beef from Matsuzaka. Fewer cattle are raised in this area, and most of the meat is eaten locally. So, Iga beef is hard to find in other parts of the country.
いただきます。わあ、うまそうですね。おいしい。This is really good. You can see why the people of Iga are very particular about their beef. Kawakami-sensei should be here almost any time now. Who are you people?
Just as I expected of an Aikido master, you performed well. Attacks in the dark of night were only part of a ninja's job. Ninjutsu is the art of stealth, the art of self-defense and survival. It's a way of gathering the knowledge for living. I hope you will learn ninjutsu as a comprehensive art of survival.
Before his initiation into the ninja ways, William decides to find out a bit more about their history.
Up until about 100 years ago, if you said a person was from Iga, you're basically talking about a ninja. In fact, many people who live in Iga today are directly descended from ninja families. Now let's go and meet one of them. Ah. Imuro-san desu ka?
Hai.
Hajimemashite, William to moshimasu.
Konnichiwa, Imuro to moshimasu.
Kyo yoroshiku onegaishimasu.
Harutoshi Imuro is descended from a family of Iga ninja. He has a document to prove it, which has been passed down from one generation to the next in the Imuro family.
One of the most famous leaders of the Iga ninja was Fujibayashi Nagato no Kami. My family had a close connection with him.
So I'm talking to the descendant of a famous ninja family. Imuro-san, Can you tell me what the ninja were all about?
To explain that, first of all, I need to explain the history of Iga.
Oh, you have a long history. Yes.
More than 1,200 years ago, before Kyoto became the capital in the 8th century, the country was made up of small realms all fighting each other.
Iga is surrounded by mountains that are often shrouded in fog. It was the perfect place for the local fighters to hide and defend themselves, and also to launch surprise attacks on their enemies. Since ancient times, people in this area built fortified residences for protection. These forts made use of the natural topography of the hills and sometimes used earthworks for greater defense. The warriors in the Iga area developed into highly skilled fighters.
These fortresses are different from the castles that were built later. We call them flat forts or medieval forts.
After Kyoto became the capital, there were bitter power struggles between the major clans. Because Iga is not far away, its fighters were drawn into the conflicts. They were used for their expertise in gathering information about their enemies.
They were local fighters who were good at stealth operations. Today, we call them ninja.
So in modern terms, we would think of something like spies being lent out by an agency, something like Mission Impossible.
These fortresses probably served as the base for those spying operations.
That's so interesting.
That's
a shuriken, or a throwing star. It's one of the best known ninja weapons, but trained ninja warriors can use anything as a weapon. For example, these.
You're saying this chopstick can be used as a weapon?
Ninja can use ordinary chopsticks, like a shuriken.
Can you show me?
I'll demonstrate.
Three of these and you're pretty much a dead man. So you can use chopsticks for a weapon. I believe you now.
If you train hard enough, you can use anything as a weapon.
Amazing. Absolutely amazing.
This is a kumihime.
A cord or a sash, yes.
A braided cord that women can wear over the obi or sash on their kimono. Even this can be a weapon.
How? Can you show me how?
If the attacker reaches for me,
grab it. It looks quite innocent, but it's actually quite effective as a weapon. Very fast. That was very impressive.
Please, try to master the kumihime techniques. You too can do it. Give it a try. It was the job of the ninja to sneak into the enemy camp and then to escape without being seen. Footwork was very important for them.
It's
Lead with your toes, placing them on the floor, lightly and silently. You lift your foot up high. Doing this helps you avoid hitting objects in the dark. The trick is to walk swiftly. Moving stealthily and moving carefully. That's the ninja way of walking. This is the sideways walking technique. Moving like this, you can keep an eye on your enemies. Sideways steps are longer than forward steps, so it's less tiring. You can pass through narrow gaps or move along a wall or other obstacles. Use your arms like this to keep your rhythm. This technique is effective when you're sneaking into a place or when you're escaping.
Ninja have also been pressed into use more recently. In 1863, when U.S. battleships were trying to force Japan to open up to the outside world, the shogunate ordered a ninja from Iga to spy inside the U.S. vessels. Yasuhiro Sawamura is the great-grandson of the famous ninja Sawamura Jinzaburo Yasusuke. For more than 1,100 years, from the 8th century, his family worked as spies, gathering intelligence. The Sawamura family still keeps a trove of ancient documents related to their ninja past. These are records written in the Edo period some 400 years ago. Called Bonsen Shukai, they describe secret ninja techniques that were never to be disclosed to outsiders. The most closely guarded secret was how to make the gunpowder used to create the flares launched in surprise attacks. It had an important role in other ways, too.
These ninja tools have been passed down in our family through the generations. This was for launching a signal flare. It was the way they communicated. This is a Mizu Taimatsu, or water torch. It's packed with gunpowder, but it's water resistant, so the flame wouldn't go out easily.
The ninja were renowned and feared for their ability to create this gunpowder. So this information had to be protected, if necessary, at the cost of their lives. Whoa!
In a time before the widespread use of fireworks powder in Japan, the ninja had already mastered a variety of uses for the substance. This made it seem to the people around them that they possessed magical powers, and it's partly behind the image that we have from the Hollywood stereotypes today.
From the civil wars of the 15th century, even up to modern times, ninja have played a big role in important historical events. But they have always kept themselves out of the spotlight. Kawakami says the most important part of ninja training has always been the spiritual aspect. The ninja go deep into the forests to conduct their intensive training practices.
Ninja training has some aspects in common with the practice of Shugendo mountain aesthetics. Both aim to acquire superhuman abilities through intense training.
Since ancient times, religious ascetics have undergone intense training regimens in the forests around Iga, a practice known as Shugendo mountain worship. Using rituals and incantations, they were thought to achieve superhuman powers.
Rin, Ryo, Do, Sha, Kai, Jin, Detsu, Zai, Zen.
You can learn superhuman abilities through this training. You'll be able to see things far away, hear the slightest sounds, and see things in the dark. Don't underestimate the powers you can obtain through concentration. The goal of training under the waterfall is to become one with it and nature. Let's see what you have learned. Williamson, you have learned much about the ninja, the arts of stealth, espionage, stratagems, sabotage, and surprise attacks. All are based on comprehensive skills for human survival. I hope you have come to understanding.
I came to Iga not knowing much about the ninja other than the typical Hollywood stereotypes. But now, having met and actually trained with people connected to the ninja tradition, I've learned two things. One, there's a lot more to the ninja than meets the eye. And two, you don't find the ninja. They find you. I hope you enjoy.